Today, I have 4 handy tips for being organized in Adobe Illustrator and to boost your workflow. So the first tip is going to allow us to create document templates, but you need to have permission to do that on your actual machine in the program files. So on a Mac, you need to head into the Adobe Illustrator application files, and for CC, you need to head into the called extras folder, and then the language folder, and then you're going to see the templates folder here. To bring up the info, press Command I on a Mac, and I'm going to guess on PC you need to write or control click the folder itself. Now at the very bottom of the information, you need to make sure that you have the read and the write permissions, as you can see on my screen here. So once you've done the technical mumbo jumbo, you can then head back into Adobe Illustrator. So let's say that you want a very specific document setup with the measurements in millimeters, a bleed settings, you know, the color mode, the size, and also the number of artboards. We can actually go ahead and create that first and foremost. To save us time and to be more organized in Illustrator, we can actually save documents as templates like so. So give it a relevant name and then go ahead and click Save. This will help a lot with your workflow in specific projects or specific types of design. When you want to open up a new document template, you can access it here. The second of 4 tips today on being more organized in Adobe Illustrator is to create custom toolbars. You can do that by coming here into the toolbar menu. Now you have a few options, and I've already created 2 custom toolbars myself, but let's go ahead and make another one too. It's just a matter of choosing the relevant tools and dragging them and dropping them into your new toolbar. This is going to help with your workflow because having a very refined toolbar is less clutter and it keeps your workspace more clear. For the third tip in today's video on being more organized, let's use this vector design here that I've made. And also the tutorial for this design is coming next week, so stay tuned for that. But this design is pretty complex, and if we take a look at my layers panel, you will see just how organized that I've been. So firstly, take the outer circle of lines as an example. It's got its own group, but I've also named that group. Now if these lines were not in a group, the layers panel would be maxed out with lines, making everything cluttered and non-organized. But secondly, making everything a group ensures that I can click and move the entire selection with ease. But another good and another useful reason for naming each layer in the layers panel is that sometimes on a complex design like this, you're not going to be able to select a design element for whatever reason. So case in point, this thick line here. When I try to select it, I end up clicking on the thin line next to it. But because I've labeled all of the layers, I can locate it in the layers panel and then just click it as I so wish. I have one more tip today for being more organized in Adobe Illustrator, and also a bonus reminder too at the very end. So the fourth tip relates to color swatches. Open up the color swatches window, and then you can actually choose colors and click and drag them into your swatches panel. Also, you can click and drag a color to the trash bin icon to remove it as well. But once you're happy with your colors and your swatches, every color that you can see in the swatch can be saved as a custom swatch by clicking the top right fly down menu. You might want a specific color scheme for a specific design or a project, and this really helps with that. So the bonus reminder in today's video is that I've actually made an entire tutorial on how to save all of your Illustrator preferences for a template, and that's linked in the top right corner of today's video, and it's also published at the very end of this video too. But remember, if you want to keep expanding your skills as a graphic designer, subscribe to Satori Graphics for weekly graphic design content. Also, like and share my videos on social media, and also have a great day. But until next time, design your future today. Peace.